But anyway, folks, basically, I made an important video here today because basically what I did when I was looking at the data, I accidentally put in, I'm pretty sure that is probably going to be the closest, not exactly absolute, but you're going to see the actual factual of, you go to watch this video of mine, and I was just throwing the data up like I always do, okay? So you go watch this video, and I was just throwing the data in there like I normally do. Just like I'm doing right now, and now I'm not absolutely don't want to scare anybody, but basically actual factual truthful data, you have never seen anything report to you that kind of a distance, okay? And as you see, because basically more than likely there's a damn good chance that it's going to enter the closest thing to us, because you've never seen the player do this before. And I will go through the player. Matter of fact, can I get it to play when it's zoomed in like this? But see, zooming in doesn't do anything. So I'll go back out, and you'll basically see that you get that figure there. And basically I can bop. There's February 15th of 2013. And that's what's going to lay on the 16th. Minus. So 8.0 E minus 4 IU. So working with integral proportional derivatives, and then I do an input interpretation of the phrase that they have on the Java player in astronomical units, and it comes down to 74,364 miles. Okay. So I would say that that's going to be the maximum that it could get at maximum distance. And the minimum I already gave you, so watch that video I showed you that I made just before this one today. Because no matter what, that's the closest thing that we can see in the next year to Earth that I've been able to find. And like I say, there's nobody that's ever showed me a video on YouTube or anything on the internet yet that's ever showed a closeness like that of all you, okay? Because you get to that, and then we get that. So magnetical pull, they're worried about. They should be. But the factual that they don't even put, like I say, they cloak and dagger everything, but conditions, because there's been conditions, I've seen condition 9, and it's stuff that went by in 2010, and it didn't come this close, okay? Because a higher condition, a condition 7 to a 9 is dangerous. Okay, higher number you get there, the higher, more dangerous it is. Like this value on the size, we showed you before that in the video, go watch the video because I don't need to re-up that. It's not that big. It's only, and I'm not worried about doing it right now, but check the video out that I just made, and I'm wondering if they did another observation and if it's not listed here, because to me it seemed like I thought it was bigger than that. Or, I mean, I thought it was something like 25, but I could have been wrong. But anyway, 24.366, we go to the chart. We go to the chart, and what I think we had again would have been 20, anything between 24.0 to 24.5. It ends up being, it's going to be something that's no bigger than 75 to 95 meters, okay? Not kilometers, meters, okay? So it's not going to be that big. But then I never even recollected listening to all the shows that I've ever seen about size of what could devastate Earth if it hit, you know? So you got to go, remember I was showing you, I've showed you data way back about all the ones that I could come up with computing the actual meteor or known impact zones on Earth that are basically hands down, every scientist in the world agrees that it was a meteor or an object from outer space that made that big divot. Everybody's golfed, or if anybody has golfed, you make a divot. Or if you ever watched a golfer, when they dig their golf ball, they make a divot when they hit that golf ball. Well, that's what will happen if we get something like a huge golf ball, asteroid, meteor, comet, or whatever that would hit us, basically. And then we know that this thing is small. So because it's basically, let me give it a computation of you for you so you realize the size of that 24.5. We'll just go with it to be the biggest. We'll go with it 95 meters. Let's go ahead and check that out. Anyway, all I've been given some very reliable information, and it's not bunk. No matter what, if it doesn't happen February 28th, something's going to happen. Humanistical, okay? There's going to be some crap go down. So if it doesn't happen February 28th, it's going to happen someday close to that. They can't do a big something and shift very often, because then the idea that it throws all their ability to do that. So anyway, no matter what, it's known that we get back to a very closeness of the distance of Earth from the sun. So, and the record that we know of there, and we were pretty darn close to that, if you remember all the videos I was doing last year. So, actual factual, it's all kind of been the sun, and they've had everybody looking around at this, that, everything like that, because it's the sun and the supergiants, ladies and gentlemen. If you research supergiants, I was the first one that actually put a supergiant site out there. You go ahead and just research the supergiants main sequence, and you will come up with all kinds of stuff. I'm not even going to go look at it, because you're going to get what you're going to get when you search that. You may get me somewhere in those searches, but they have kind of pushed Beano to the back on all those searches, because basically everything I give you is actual, 1,000% factual truth, 100% facts, data, okay? Actual truth, not presume, not assume. Now, presume and assume is pretty damn close. Things look so solid that it's a legal case where the idea, let's charge the son of a you-know-what's, okay? Either. So, we got to have something that all I know is through anything. Let's just go the quietest you can hear. February 28th of 2013, something's going to happen. So no matter what, this is our object. And once again, I'll just kind of basically stay here on this so everybody gets out to knowing that this actually is the only thing I know that's close or going to get this close. And as you see, that's the computation dates, and you can play around with this by looking at Earth is right there underneath it. What I can do is I can hit backup, and then you'll see the trajectory of it as it would be, and then we'll just hit, and as we were going in, we'll hit that, and I don't know if I can, I can flip the trajectory around a little bit, and you'll see that we come to February 13th. There you go. And so, and as you see, that's how it goes through the player. So then we'll back up, and that'll bring it back. Now it looks like the Earth is chasing it, and it's not, because basically we're in reverse. And we will hit, there's the 15th. And then we will back it up some more. And there you go. And then we'll move this as it was going, because we're going back in time. We'll get close to today. So you'll kind of know where this is at. We'll get around to, there you go. This is the 15th of this month. And let's just move this so you realize. So it's still kind of close by us right now. So 212 DA14 is out there. And it's the closest thing we're going to ever have seen. And I'm trying to remember anything what was the closest that we had last year. Of all those stuff where we put the red alerts out and everything like that. Because we're like, oh, this is close. You know, this is close. And then we learn over time that all that stuff, it's just hella out there. But it does do magnetical and so forth and so on. And now I'll hit forward and we'll get the whole spiel as we go by. And now, oh, there we went. And then we go back, and basically I'm just, you know, playing around with the player. And we'll get back up to today. And as you see, we're backing up. So it looks like Earth is chasing it, but we're not. Because I'm backing up through time. So now we'll get around to... And there we go. We got April 16th of this month. Okay, now it's the 26th already, so we'll go over to the 26th. And then we will go ahead and then there you go, in stereo play out there. And then we've also got, I'm trying to remember, I haven't played with these for a long time. There you go. So right now, it's pretty much on the, it's our right wing. So it's our right wingman right now. And then we will go ahead and we'll, and we're going ahead. Now, and there's more accurate, so now we'll go ahead. And there we, that's pretty much how we rotate around the sun and so forth. And as you see Earth there, and we've got 212 DA14 hanging out up there. Now I would think that you would think that the military, since that size, now let's go look at the meter size of that thing up, and we would think that we should blow this thing to smithereens, you'd think. Just for the hell of it, but we'll see what happens. We'll see what they do. Let Mother Nature take its court or what? I don't know. So but you got to go to see what the scientists figure of what size of something that could come through our atmosphere that would survive, that would do what, you know. What do they actually figure that could, at what speed and so forth? Because basically I've already jibber-jabbered and went past the, we've got to get back up to January 16th of... And then we get it on the 16th. So, and again, you see the computation doesn't change. It's that, and it's that distance from the sun. Okay. Now, remember, on the 28th, sun distance is going to be this, UOA. And, I mean, on this date, and then on. Actually, we should get it here too to see what. We'll go to the 28th, and we'll see what. All I know is there's going to be something, man, something humanistical is going to happen. And then we're at that. All I know, it's just, it's not bunk. So I'll tell you that right now. So, or it's going to happen before then or close by it. Something's going to happen. Something big in the world news. Okay, so NASA has this compute dated out at 1.01 AU then. Now, if you got a real quick mind and you're looking at the numbers, this is what it's supposed to be on that date. So, is that object going to possibly hit what? Because that's going to be our distance from the sun. Remember, it shows it being that distance, 998 something from the sun on that date. So, I'll get you a distance on the object in on that date, because we know that that's unusual there. Okay. So, sun distance will be that far away from it. And then you've seen what the Earth is going to be that day. So like I say, big bangs, because the idea, the distance from the sun on the 16th, when that closest object that we know, so big bangs, folks, there's been way more than one big bang, because that's very damn close to our, a matter of fact, yes, very damn close to our nearest distance from orbit center of the sun before, okay? So that's damn close to that. So it's going to be interesting to find out when our actual closeness to the sun is. So I'll try to do that over time. But no matter what, astronomers and everything, we're going to be able to see this. You're going to be able to pick this up with your naked eye, you would think, because if it's